a little old kid. So I made my first railroad out of sardine cans. I'd whittle me out of shape of an engine out of a piece of 2x4, and then I'd put bed casters on it for wheels, and then tie them in, then car tie about 7 or 8 of them sardine cans, and I had me a train.
Question about it. Cities have got a real need for rapid transit. If everybody drove a car downtown, we'd have a giant traffic jam. So my guess is that the passenger train is going to make a comeback. A different form, like electric motors, concrete ties, and welded rails. Well, I mean, nothing like the old steam engine days. But we've got a real need now to transport a lot of people in a very small amount of space, very quickly.
Right in this room, we control the movement of the trains, even though they can be hundreds of miles away. The lights here indicate their location. When we have two trains coming head on each other, we put one train off onto a siding and let the other one pass, and then we automatically put the first train back on its main track and it just goes right on its way.
We've gone to new kinds of cars, auto cars, piggyback cars, double-sized cars. Big problems, adding cars up to make a train. Well, in the modern hump yard, we use gravity and computers to sort cars out. We just roll all the cars up a hill, separate them, and let them roll down. The computer tells us which track and even applies brakes so the cars don't roll too fast and smash up. Railroads are very active today. We just don't carry many people anymore. We carry cargo.